Thank you very much, Sure. You've given us a very good overview in terms of the vertical and the horizontal integration approaches and challenges that are happening in Taiwan. And I think these are very much relatable to our audience in the Philippines. Maybe one question that was chatted to me as well. This is a very interesting question in terms of the, you mentioned that cities currently, you know, are also doing, let's say, city-specific policies, approaches. Do you see any challenges in terms of, you know, taking such quite city-specific approaches? Are there going to be tensions with regards to, do you foresee tensions with regards to the, let's say, some of the national regulations, for example, or are these almost totally in line with what the ministries are putting in place? And are there specific mechanisms for dialogues where cities can also discuss and learn from each other in your case? And if you can, you know, just provide us some insights on what you recommend in terms of like peer-to-peer type of discussions on this. Thank you.
Sure. Yeah, that's a good question. I think tension-wise between different levels of governance, say the building code is a very good example. The Ministry of Interior announced a building code for basically the safety reason. I think one of the speakers mentioned early on about the challenges how to make sure the charging poles or charging facility safe. Yes, the national government stepped something around that, but how, it's just very fundamental, very basic, but in reality in cities there are different type of building styles and different kind of complex building complex. So I think cities definitely didn't see that sufficient. They had to come up with something that fits their purposes, but there is always the gap saying, oh, the national government didn't really take into account this type of building into consideration. So there, I think a lot of back and forth, and because local government didn't really want to make decisions on their own to bear that liability. So there were a lot of meetings between national and local governments. That's one thing they even had. That is more about peer-to-peer exchange. The second point is that I think in light of this, I think earlier this year, maybe during the summertime, July, August, they had a meeting. All cities had a meeting together with the national government to talk about how the best to install charging poles in parking garages and parking facilities. So they did a bit of an inventory check to see how many charging poles are there currently in private and public parking spaces and how many more they could achieve and what are the challenges. So they talked about how the best to install on-street parking poles, because some cities don't have the capacity and some cities do. So I think even though it's not really an official peer-to-peer exchange, but they exchange the information through simply just the parking meeting, like, oh, how the best to improve the parking facility. And the conversation was actually all about installing the electricity, installing the charging poles.
Thank you very much, Tsu-jui. I think that's a very important point to consider, at least in the case of the Philippines, also in terms of elevating the discussions that involve also the local government units in terms of and their interaction in relation to what is being done at the ministerial level.